Hey, good morning, everybody. This is Steven with SW Pressure Washing. Today, I'm going to do a video on how to clean concrete. If you're a intermediate or a expert in this field, this video probably not pertain to you. It's pretty much for beginners. Right now, I'm at AutoZone, and I'm about to clean the rear of their building. See where I stopped at last week. So I'm gonna clean this area here, and also this concrete over here. That docking area, gonna get that clean, and also behind those that dumpster pad that's sitting over there. So this is what we're cleaning, and we're gonna stop right here. I cleaned all that over there about a month ago. So we're gonna get from here, all of this down. It's not gonna take us long to do it. But I'm gonna show you, mostly this staining that's on here is really organic staining. I'm gonna go ahead and spray this off, even though I cleaned it already. As you can see, I cleaned it already. So it looked like the mulch people came and did a little damage over here. Which is fine. We're gonna clean it up. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm going to downstream, maybe like a 2% mix of just SH only. I'm gonna use this downstreamer right here. Let's see if I can find my remote. Let's find the remote. As y'all can see, my truck is dirty. It's fine. No big deal. I'm not trying to impress anybody. The question is what did I do with my remote? Let's see. What did I do with my remote? Remote. I normally keep all my other stuff in here. But the question is, where is the remote? So I'm gonna show y'all everything I'm doing is unedited, is raw, foul found it. And this the remote I'm gonna use for my downstreaming. This the stuff that we normally go through doing pressure washing. You know, people make things look like all just easy breezy, and it could be that way if you had the right setup. I'm running a 4 gallon a minute hot water along with another 4 gallon a minute, but I only combine both of those when I'm doing flat work, when I'm using my Mundo. So what we're going to do first is we're going to warm the engines up, throttle it on, go ahead, throttle this way, gasoline on, I'm gonna cut it down some. This is all, this is nothing but organic staining. There's no oil stains, there's no calcium, there's nothing up here that I should be concerned about. It's just all weather damage, and we're going to clean it up, and I'm going to show y'all how easy it is. So let's see, let's cut my water on. out of it. Whatever that crap is. That's why you, if you seen that, that color that came through that water, that's why it's very important. So even though it was that color, if it was any type of grime or anything that was coming through that water, that filter caught it. All right? So let's cut this off. And now I'm gonna hook my DNT valve, ball valve into my pressure wall. Alright, it's hooked up. Cut it off. And I'm using the soap. Let's put it on the soap. I do apologize. Yeah, let's put it on the soap. Hold on one second. Downstream, y'all. It's downstream. So I have my remote. And I'm going to cut it off. The blue light is ready to go. Let's make sure I'm pulling my SH. I get on. Oh, I need a fan too. Hold on one second, y'all. Okay, this hurts to be pulling my SA. Now it's coming through 100 foot of hole. Yeah, while I'm over here, might as well rinse that off. Come on now, let's pull it. I don't think my pressure is low enough. Only way it will work, your pressure has to be very low for it to draw a vacuum to pull from to pull from your chemical injector. So I'm gonna just show y'all what I'm going through. Let's try the tip right here. Pulling the SH. All right, so let's start. Let's give me enough holes. go ahead and treat this area with SH. So this is nothing but SH that I'm throwing out here. Nothing fancy. Wetting the concrete down with SH. Alright, simple as that. So let me sit this down and let's fire this up. Well, one of my I think high pressure check valve has failed on me. So what I have to do is release some of this pressure. Get that pressure out my one so my other unit can fire up. So we're gonna check everything. I have my line open here. This one for my buffer, and also that line is open. Show my gas line is open, choke is on. Open up the bypass. So I just open my bypass back up. And the SH I put on there is maybe 1.5-2%. Because of your downstream. So it's diluted a lot, so not too much to worry about. Put the load on. Alright, let's crank this back up. Y'all, this speak. Mind for that, I'm trying to do this and hold this camera at the same time. Let me see if I can get to work for this camera to mount. Let's check this out. Oh, we got the wall. This is what we want to see if we can get this angle here. Now I gotta realize I'm using a cell phone, so there's nowhere to mount this camera. Let's see if I can hold it. Y'all, it's taking me some time because I'm just showing y'all that we don't take much. Let's unhook this. as you can see, all I have to do is rinse. And y'all, if I wasn't holding this camera, I gotta get a better camera in the future. I'm gonna show y'all how easy to rinse is. To clean this stuff off. So let me go to clean this off and I'm gonna start the video back up when I do the concrete. All right, we back. So I have already cleaned that area, as you can see, cleaned that off, and that's nothing but a 2% SH mist. So nothing but SH, no type of debris. So what I'm going to do now, and I'm finished, I'm going to pre-treat from here is mine, over back there. So I got my remote. So I'm gonna do less talking, I'm gonna do more working, all right? So I'm gonna show y'all the process. Downstream, 2%, no staining back here, just organic. 2% SH will take care of it. And that's all I'm about to do. Downstream. right, so remember, all I did was use a 2% SH mix. Well, it's not a mix, just regular SH. And I'm gonna let this sit for about 2 or 3 minutes while I get my surface cleaner, and we'll get the cleaner, and I'm gonna show you how quick this is gonna go. Simple. how quick that was? So now I'm about to rinse it off. It's done.
Now y'all see what I see, right? Over there on that side, I have a few lines. So all I'm going to do is post-treat it. Post-treat is just like pre-treatment. Post-treatment is nothing but throwing back 2%, 1.5%, 2% on top of what you cleaned already. And let it just walk away. You don't want to put a strong mix on it because you don't want people that stuff on the bottom of people's shoes or tracking. Somebody may bring their dog or something back here. You don't want that. So that's how you clean. Just regular organic staining, no oil stains, no type of major stains that I was concerned of. As you can see, it was done pretty quick. So I'll be back with the final product, what I cleaned and everything, and I'll see y'all in the future.